Okay, so we've got a standard form question here, one where we've been asked to turn a standard form, sorry, a normal number into standard form. So I've got 0.00037, and the way to do that is I need to turn this into a number between 1 and 9.9 recurring. So I put my decimal point between the 3 and the 7, so I've written 3.7 down there. Because it's really small, I know that this has got to be a negative power, so all I need to do is to make sure that I get my negative there and work out what how many places to move the decimal point. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 places to move it into the correct place, and that gives me a -4 indice. Writing 8.25 times by 10 to the power of 3 is an ordinary number. I write down 8.25, I've given myself some extra zeros to play with at the end, so I just need to calculate how many places to move my decimal point. So I've got 3 here, so come along 1, 2, 3, and I end up with 8,250. Now, working out 2.1 times by 10 to the power of 8 by 6 times by 10 to the power of minus 5, I'm going to have to be, I've got two different ways of doing this, a calculator and a non-calculator method. Let me show you the non-calculator method first of all. So I'm going to do 2.1 times by 6, and I get 12.6. I then need to remember that when I times standard form, I add the indices. So 8 plus minus 5, which I've written down here. Well, 8 plus minus 5, a plus and a minus makes a minus. So 8 minus 5 is 3. So I've essentially got 12.6 times by 10 to the power of 3. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn that back into standard form again, because we know that the number at the start of standard form has to be between 1 and 9.9 recurring. So I turn 12.6 into 1.26, therefore making it 10 times smaller. So to accommodate that, I increase the power by 1, therefore making it 10 times bigger. Now, a calculator method for this, we've got to use this button down at the bottom of my calculator. So I type in 2.1, I press that button, and then 8, so that's 2.1 times by 10 to the power of 8, times by 6, press the button again, and I use this negative button here to the power of 5. So I get 12,600. So I could write my 12,600 down and then turn that back into standard form again using the method that I've shown you before.